Antarctica, New York. Respond to the music for the Superfly.
Superfly Snooker.
Here he comes to the ring, and what a tremendous athlete this man is in the World Wrestling Federation. And he's ready to go too.
Oh, doesn't he look intense? My word, look at him there. I've always looked at Snooker's eyes and wondered what goes on behind them. I know that he is a fantastic wrestler, and he certainly must give a lot of thought to his opponents because he seems to be able to control and master them even in the most difficult and adverse of conditions.
Well, it's obvious here as the fans watch on that Superfly has had his problems with the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, especially when it concerns the Honky Tonk Man, and I know he's thinking about that as he steps in here against Dino Bravo. And also has to, oh, watch out! A big clothesline, and the Superfly goes right to the floor, so Bravo starts out early.
He really did. That was a beautiful move by Bravo. He came in there and caught the Superfly completely unawares, and the Superfly, I must admit, was actually caught napping there, and that's a most unusual situation because his mind and his attention were not diverted at all by the mouth of South Jimmy, Jimmy Hart. In fact, Jimmy Snooker, the Superfly, has only himself to blame.
Watch out, an outside in vertical suplex coming here. Oh, nicely done. That time from Bravo dropped him down on the back of his neck. And Dino Bravo is quick to put the offense to Jimmy Snooker, and he may be out right here. No, sir. Jimmy Snooker with a lot of reserve left, kicking out quite nicely there. Now, Jimmy Superfly Snooker also involved in SummerSlam as he'll go up against the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, in what should be a tremendous match.
Definitely. The Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, one of the greatest wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation. In fact, in my book, one of the greatest wrestlers of all time. And Jimmy Snooker's got to face that man. But Snooker, my goodness gracious, what a tremendous wrestler he is.
Good leapfrog from Snooker. And a chop sending Bravo down, but Bravo right back up. Look at this, a big pickup. Dino Bravo, a gigantic man, but Superfly picked him up with a great deal of ease that time, and now drops the knee down. One, two, Jimmy Superfly Snooker coming back here, but Bravo kicking out.
That was a great demonstration just then of Superfly's pinpoint accuracy. When he leapt in the air, he knew exactly where he was at all times and came down with that knee with maximum effect to the sternum of Dino Bravo.
Into the corner, Bravo shooting, nope, good reversal. It's Bravo who shot in that time. Back drop. Superfly into the corner with a drop kick. Got that right leg up right on the head of Bravo, who rolls out to the feet of Jimmy Hart.
Well, fortunately for Bravo, he was just able to get outside the power range of Superfly there, and he did catch that drop kick, but nowhere near as devastating as it might have been. In fact, look at Bravo. He's back on his feet now, very, very strong. And at the behest of Jimmy Hart, he's going to come back into that ring and really try and make his presence felt very, very heavily once again.
Bravo back in. And Bravo now wants to get Jimmy Superfly Snooker down to earth with a show of strength.
Yes, he's employing that Greco knuckle lock there, that he's going to try and outstrength the Superfly, but I don't know whether he will be able to do that or not, because Superfly also possesses, shall I say this, superhuman strength for a Superfly.
Well, let's see how superhuman he can be with the Greco knuckle lock. So far, it's all Dino Bravo, but you got to give Snooker a lot of vote of courage there.
And a lot of credit, yes, absolutely. He did accept that challenge, and it may have been a little bit foolhardy because Bravo has got him right down on one knee and possibly going to two.
Pushing the Superfly down, Jimmy Snooker still down on one knee. How can he get out of this? Look at this, using some leg strength there, Alfred, to power back up.
Yes, that was very, very good indeed. The courage the Superfly is showing here, really tremendous.
To the midsection, Bravo. Jimmy Snooker just stepped right out of that. What a move, but Bravo nails him with a great clothesline to the head.
And that indeed was a devastating clothesline. And Bravo, he doesn't seem to have any real set game plan here, except to just try and take Superfly apart methodically.
Out of it is Superfly Jimmy Snuka with a kick out. Now from behind, a knee to the back. Jimmy Snuka on the receiving end as you take a look at it. The paint on his face and the reverse chin lock applied with that knee right to the back.
And look at the face of Dino Bravo taking sadistic pleasure in everything that he's doing to the Superfly now. And there on the outside, of course, we've got that very, very quick look, once again, thank you, cameraman, of the mouth of the South there, Jimmy Hart, really urging his man on. And he really is a great force to have behind you for any wrestler.
The Superfly trying to get to his feet. He's at one knee, but Bravo continues the reverse chin lock. Now the Superfly up. And he gets nailed in the back by Bravo with that forearm shot. Nicely done again. So Bravo executing quite well, as we've seen so many times from this big Canadian. And once again to the back.
And I would say at this point, Tony, that I'm sure the million-dollar Ted DiBiase must be watching this match and maybe getting a little confidence in seeing Superfly being treated so abusively by Dino Bravo.
Certainly the style of the million-dollar man is not the same as Dino Bravo.
No, not at all. But he could be learning some lessons here, though.
He could be learning any possible weaknesses on the part of Jimmy Snuka. One thing you're going to have to say, Alfred, and it applies to Bravo as Jimmy Hart watches on, and also applies to the million-dollar man, that the key to being successful against the Superfly is to keep him off of the ropes.
Yes, and to try and keep what Bravo is doing now, close physical contact. Because once this man can become aerial, or once he's like in a mode where he can hit you with speed, you're lost. Bravo waging a very, very intelligent match here indeed.
Jimmy Snuka has been in this bear hug for quite a while now. And now is up, a couple of chops to the trapezius muscles. And again, once again, down on the top of the shoulders, the Superfly trying to get out. Big headbutt, and that's sagging Bravo. The Superfly, as Bravo drops down. They collide, and it's Jimmy Snuka who took the brunt of that, Alfred.
Yes, that was a heavy, heavy collision there. He was face-to-face, came head-on with Dino Bravo, and the superior weight that Bravo carries put Superfly right through the ropes, crashing heavily to the ground outside. And now I would say that Superfly is finding himself in dire, dire circumstances indeed.
To the head. Big headbutt. The Superfly on the top. What a great move. But no, Bravo had moved out of the way. Jimmy Snuka with a world of agility right there. But it didn't work. And now he moves out of the way. Dino Bravo with a roundhouse that missed everything. The Superfly with the atomic drop. So the action picks up now. And that's always in the favor of Superfly, Jimmy Snuka.
A Superfly now being able to execute those aerial moves. That first one off the top rope didn't connect, but it certainly shook up Dino Bravo. And now Superfly going right to the very, very top. And look at this.
Jimmy Hart grabbing the leg of Jimmy Snuka. Snuka grabbing Jimmy Hart. And now look from behind. It's Bravo. Jimmy Snuka out of the way. Here he comes. Driving the knee in. Dino Bravo out on the floor.
And I think very fortunately for Bravo that he was able to tumble through the ropes there, because it certainly looked, we have a decision here by the referee. Well, what was that decision?
Winner by the way of the-